Look around you and nearly everything you can see or touch has been engineered. From your mobile phone to the chair you're sitting in, there are millions of simple and more complex products that have been designed, tested, and made by engineers. Raytheon's Quadcopter Challenge brings together all the skills of engineering in one amazing competition. When a quadcopter arrives, it's a collection of parts and instructions that require mechanical engineering to bring them all together. First, there's the mechanics of the build, connecting various parts, ensuring they align, making sure the quadcopter's weight is evenly distributed, otherwise it may struggle to fly. Then, mechanical engineering deals with all the forces, like mass, strength, and aerodynamics. In an average family car, for example, there are 30,000 connected and moving parts that must be durable, reliable, and completely fit for purpose. That's no different to our quadcopters. We need a machine that will withstand an occasional crash landing, but is also easy to repair if something breaks. Ever since the discovery of electricity and invention of the silicon chip, electronic engineering has become one of the fastest growing areas of industry. Your mobile phone now has 100,000 times more processing power than was used in the Apollo 11 guidance computers, and they put a man on the moon. Our quadcopters rely on electronic engineering for power, flight, and even LED lights. The onboard computer, or the brain of the quadcopter, wirelessly receives signals from a handheld controller, telling the motors what to do to control direction, speed, and lift. In just the same way that onboard computers manage that information in today's cars and aircraft. Turning human inputs into machine outputs is what electronic engineering is all about. Bringing together all the elements of mechanics and electronics is what we call systems engineering. Our quadcopters are working systems of components. Some, like the LED lights, are independent, but most are interconnected. This leads to trade-offs among engineers. An example could be making the quadcopter stronger so it's less likely to break. But if you use a heavy material, the quadcopter will require more power to operate and the battery will drain more quickly. Working through challenges like these are the kinds of problems that Raytheon engineers love to solve. The Quadcopter Challenge is a great way for students to learn and use exactly the same skills and thinking.